Today, we have more phones than people in the world. And we're not too far from a future where everything we buy, everything we see, will be connected to the internet. My lab is working to make this vision possible and tap into the goldmine of information that wireless signals have to offer about us and our environment. So in my lab, we're building next generation wireless networks. We want to create a world where not just every person, but every object is also connected to the internet. This next generation network can provide a lot more than just internet connectivity. It can provide a host of new services. So imagine attaching a $2 tag to your mail and then use it to track its location anywhere in the world. By analyzing the signals from these tags, we can track its location at a fraction of the power that GPS consumes. But beyond tracking location, wireless signals can also provide us valuable information about the environment. We're building a system that allows autonomous vehicles and autonomous robots to detect pedestrians using ambient wireless signals. We're building wafer-thin tags that can be attached to your clothing and be used to track body gestures no matter where you are, indoors or outdoors. Such a system can be used to track your fitness and learn about how your body moves in your day-to-day life. This information is there in the signals that we perceive around us. It's just that we have to figure out and learn how to pick it up. The biggest challenge in developing these networks is scale. How can we build a network where we have millions of devices in a city that attempt to communicate at the same time without interfering? And how can their signals reach a base station several miles away using just a coin-sized battery? Our lab is developing the wireless protocols for these devices to efficiently coexist, communicate, and still last 10 years on a battery. But then there are projects that are even more long-term, like what would be the next generation network? How will we get our connectivity from megabits per second to gigabits per second? And these are much more long-term questions that my lab is also addressing. 10 years ago, we didn't think that our radios can do megabits per second. Maybe 10 years from now, they'll do gigabits per second. We'll need a lot more bandwidth, and we need networks to support this bandwidth. I want to democratize the internet even more. I want to have more objects, more people. I want connecting to the internet to be something that costs, you know, a dollar or two. What does it take to do that? I think this is an open question for the research community, and this is an open question that I would like to address.